Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey, your friendly neighborhood web designer. This is the final video, part four of our AI-powered web designer series where we used AI from the very beginning of landing a client to creating copy, content, sitemaps, product lists, menu items, all the way through to designing our site and creating creative assets, all with the help of AI. Now, in this video, we're gonna take our mockup that we designed in our previous video, and we're gonna turn that into a fully dynamic, responsive site. So let's fire up Editor X and let's build that site. Here, I'm gonna start out by adding all the pages to the site pages menu. Then I'm gonna turn on Wix stores, which will allow me to enable e-commerce. Then I'm gonna add a new menu and make sure all the pages are added, including the shopping cart and account menu. I've uploaded a custom slab font, changed all the headings, the typography, and added the colors from my Figma design. That's my blue and yellow colors. From the add panel, I'm gonna add a pre-designed welcome section, which looks nice. Change the background image to that AI art we created in a previous video. We're gonna update our heading text, make that background a little bit more contrasty, add our text from our design, update these buttons, make that header sticky, update the colors of the active and links. Let's throw in our brand new logo that we designed. Then we're going to update these buttons and the text to make sure it looks good. Perfect. Let's add ourselves a new section, and then I'm going to add a container, split it into a 2x1 grid. In the first part of the grid, I'm going to create a nice little container that matches our design. And when I complete this, I'm going to save that as an asset to a new library called Tony. That's gonna allow me to just drag another one in to match the previous design. Nice and efficient. Gonna tidy up some of the text, the buttons, and we're good to go. Let's pop a little spacing in that section. Then we're gonna add a new section. It's gonna look like this in our design. Lots of cool layered effects here. So we're gonna add our image, some text, the typography and content from the design, throw a button in there, align things up, check it out on the browser. Looking good so far. Let's throw in our nice layered image, drag and drop it where we want it to go, animate it on load, add the second one, drag it where we want to go, make some adjustments, and we're going to animate this one on load as well. Let's give it a preview in the browser, make sure it works. Lovely. And now it's time to add our grid product gallery. I know this doesn't exactly match our design in the mockup, but I realized that I kind of like this better and it saves me some time customizing a layout. So I'm just going to make some adjustments to the design and the branding to make sure it matches the style of the rest of the site. I'm gonna give this a little preview in the browser, and it has a cool quick view pop-up modal window here, and that looks nice as well. So now what we're gonna do is go back and add ourselves a new section and get moving to the final part of the homepage. Saving some massive time here with Editor X. In our compositions, I could just drag a footer that looks really good and a pre-footer that also looks nice, matches the design, the style that we're going for, update the text, the colors, the buttons, make sure everything looks good, especially on responsive views. Then now what we're gonna do is open it up, check out the final version of our home page. Woo, looking spicy. All right, so now it's time to add our products. I'm gonna manage our products, open up the content manager, has a whole bunch of default products. I'm just gonna delete those, start from scratch. Adding some physical products here. I can add images, I can add the names, any ribbons, if it's a bestseller, descriptions, prices, pre-order. I can do anything here from updating the marketing and SEO to tracking inventory taxes and whatnot. Because I only have 5 products here, I don't mind adding each and every individual product in this way. It's a little time consuming, but again, there's only 5 products. It shouldn't take that long. In the next segment here, we're going to be adding some menu items, and there's a lot of menu items, so we're actually going to batch those using a CSV file. I'll show you that in a moment. Here's what this looks like on the page so far, and this is looking so good. All right, time to design our menu page. Got a new header here with a background, nice contrast for the text. Add a new section, throw in this repeater. I'm going to change this to be called Tony Specials. I'm going to update this grid here so that it looks the way I want my menu to look. So here's what we're going to work with. All right, so now it's time to connect this repeater to a data set. So I'm gonna create a collection, call it menu items. I'm gonna add multiple items, and here we are with our full list of menu items. Now I could manually add all these, but it's gonna take a long time. So I'm gonna import a CSV file that's formatted properly, match and map all the columns so that I can import that. And here is the entire menu. That is awesome, took me a minute. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select each individual element and then use this little connector icon to connect each piece to an item in the content manager. And because this is a repeater, it's going to, if I update one row, it's going to affect and update every single other row dynamically. So here we have a fully dynamic menu that Tony can update himself using the easy to use content manager. And there it is. From the very beginning, we used AI to help us land the client, come up with some good questions to ask the client. We created content, a full copy deck, menu items, sitemap, product list. Then we created an AI assisted design, branding, and mood board. We took that, brought it into Figma, created a nice polished final version of Tony the Deli Guy's website. And then here we turned that into a fully dynamic restaurant website, complete with an e-commerce store where you can buy products and a dynamic menu that Tony himself can update easily without breaking our design, all using AI and Editor X. Friends, if you like this series, make sure you subscribe to the channel for more of these series. And if you want to continue the conversation about building and growing your creative business as a designer, a developer, as a no-code creator, come join us in the Creative X crew. The link is in the pinned comment just below this video. Would love to see you there. It's free. We meet every single week. It's your group to network, to collaborate, to find vendors, partners, clients, and more. Come join us in the Creative X crew. Thanks for watching, friends, and we'll see you in another video.